CNA folder, what is the most important thing for you? As of now, in this folder, you can see this diagram and spreadsheet. In this folder, we have everything for you. So secure CRT, some slides are we also already copied, but this is the folder you will be working most of the time. In this folder, we have a spreadsheet called CCNA Security ASA Firewall Student Username and Password. This is the spreadsheet we have. Okay, in this actually, we have allocated the VLANs to you. We have allocated the PC to you as well. And each of you can be working on this folder. So this is the folder which shows you which VLAN you have been associated. Okay, what is the remote desktop machine you have? What is the username and password of the remote desktop machine you have? For example, if I want to access 10.250.21, I can open MSDSC, remote desktop application. Everybody should know that, how we can do this. 10.250.21. And you can see, what is the username and password? That's the machine I have logged in. Okay? So I can log into this machine. Then you can see what is my LAN interface, what is the name I'm going to associate, what is the security level I have, what is the VLAN inside, what is the IP address. So based on these criteria, we will be creating our LAN interfaces, we will be creating our DMZ interfaces, which interface we will be used, are you going to use security level as well. This is the last time we have discussed already, security level. As you know, the traffic follow from the higher to lower security level. This is the outside interface. These are the outside interface will be GIG00. And the outside VLAN will be, this is the IP address you will be assigning. The internet side, this is the interface IP we have. Interface, we will be having only one interface. And this is the IP address we will be assigning. Our PAT IP, our NAT IP, our external machine, and their username and password. Okay, so this is the, you will be referring to that. Along with that, there are diagrams as well. If you see this CCNA security diagram and check the VLAN you are working in, I have allocated the VLAN to you. Zeki, for example, 22, JSC 23, Nia is 24. All of you have been assigned this. You can go into these VLAN and you can open inside there. You can see there are multiple diagram. So this is a physical diagram. The physical diagram show you how the devices are connected. Just the physical interfaces only. Okay, we have a test machine here, a desktop machine here. So this is our desktop machine. And the desktop machine, okay, forget this one actually for the time being. It's not used anymore now in our topology because this was for CCNA security. We don't need it anymore. You can see there's a table here as well. Each of the router interface. So forget router. With this, this machine is directly connecting to the ASA with the IP address we will be seeing. Okay, so this machine, the desktop I am using for test machine, it has two interfaces. As you can see, it has two interfaces. One for our management, we RDP into this machine. Okay, 10.250.21. And one is connecting to our firewall side. Okay, 10.121.100. Okay. And then this is a logical diagram. In the logical diagram, we can see there is a IP addressing scheme has been introduced. So forget about router. Your machine is directly connected to this firewall. Then firewall will switch the traffic coming from this machine to internet, to external network, to DMZ. Okay. So you will see everything will be working from this machine, even from home as well. So firewall, we have internal IP, inside IP, inside interface. We have DMZ interface, we have outside interface, we have internet interface. So this is the diagram. If you can see, this is a table. This table is showing you, this is exactly what you can see in the real world environment as well. You will be working through the diagram or the spreadsheet. Okay, so if somebody report me any problem, I always request him, give me the diagram, because from the diagram I can see how the traffic is going from here and there. In our topology, you can see that this diagram, this is the default route here, sending out the traffic to firewall, then the firewall can switch the traffic to DMZ, to the outside, to the internet side as well. Okay, and there are multiple diagrams are already there. Please visit your allocated VLAN, and you can see there are many diagrams, physical, logical. When you do the routing, you will be completing your routing diagram from here as well. We will be running OSPF, we will be running static routes. Then we have a NAT, okay? Then we have the static NAT, how the traffic will be coming from the static NAT, we can test it. Then we have, this is not required for the time being, okay? We have the VPN, remote VPN. We will be learning the theoretical and practical, and we have the SSL VPN, Cisco AnyConnect as well, okay? Most importantly, we also have the failover as well. How the firewall will work if the primary goes down and the backup will take over. So that's the Bible for you. If you want to know which VLAN you are working, everybody should know which VLAN they are working. Look at this spreadsheet. This spreadsheet is in the folder number 5, diagram spreadsheet. And maybe you not be able to, whatever I have updated here. Okay, everybody please note this down. If you have downloaded, maybe it's not updated. But what you can do is just go into this spreadsheet online and you will see the up-to-date status of which VLAN you are working. Clear? Yeah, okay, that's the physical topology we are showing you. Sorry? And that's the physical topology we are showing you, that there is a server. And this server has many, many machines. Like you can see, this server has many machines here. And in the diagram, you can see these are the machines we have provided you for the testing. Okay? These are the machines we provided you for the testing. We will initiate all the traffic from here. And you can see the firewall have 3 interfaces, E01, E02, E00. They are connecting to different switches. And these switches are like, they are connected to DMZ router, outside router, and we have the outside router is connected to the internet. So this is a physical diagram, physical connection of our devices. Any questions so far? Zaki, you okay?